This video talks about feedback, in particular negative feedback in amplifiers. Feedback is a very powerful concept and has numerous applications. By definition, feedback is the process of combining the output of a system with its input. It can be said that feedback stabilizes a system. However, not all types of feedback have this property. There are two types of feedback, positive and negative. Negative feedback stabilizes, while positive feedback has the opposite effect. Positive feedback occurs when the system output is added to the system input, whereas negative feedback occurs when the system output is subtracted from its input. Examples of positive feedback are oscillators. A ring oscillator is a cascade of an odd number of inverters with a feedback. The first feature of the ring oscillator is the logical instability. If we put a high value in the input, we have a low value at the end of the cascade, which is fed back in the input by the feedback, putting the input to low value, which in turn produces a high value at the end of the cascade, and so on. There is a combinatorial contradiction and the circuit is unstable. So in oscillators, we use the feedback to generate the instability we need for the oscillation. But let's talk about negative feedback in amplifier. A generic amplifier has a gain dependent on the frequency, which we call A of j omega. The OL stands for open loop, telling us that this is the gain without feedback. Amplifier often has some issues. For example, often they can suffer of limitation of bandwidth or distortion, or their gain could be variable because of temperature, or their gain can be so high that make them unusable, like operational amplifier. In these cases, the solution is the negative feedback. As you see, when we close the loop, the input of the amplifier XI is the difference between the source input and the feedback signal. The output is the open loop gain times the input XI. The feedback factor beta is defined as the signal feedback XF over the output signal XO, and the closed loop gain is defined as XO over the input source signal XS. Keeping in mind these definitions, we derive the closed loop gain as function of the open loop gain and the loop factor beta. The first observation we can do is that the closed loop gain is less than the open loop gain AOL, so with the feedback we lose some gain, but often we won't it. The second observation is that if AOL becomes very large, then the closed loop gain becomes 1 over beta, so we lose the dependency on the open loop gain and we have a dependence only on the feedback components, which we can exploit for achieving stability. When used in the design of amplifiers, feedback can provide a number of advantages. These advantages include desensitizing the gain to process parameter variation, reducing nonlinear distortion, reducing the effect of noise, extending the useful bandwidth of the amplifier, and controlling the input and output impedance levels. Let's see the feedback advantages one by one. Since the value of the open loop gain AOL is large, its value may change significantly with temperatures, mismatch of devices, and other parameter variations. However, negative feedback desensitizes the closed loop gain from change in the open loop gain. Therefore, differentiating the closed loop gain in respect to open loop gain, we get this equation, which we can write in this way. Now let's say the open loop gain is 10,000 and beta is 1 over 10. Then a change of 10% in the open loop gain becomes 0.01% in the closed loop gain. So changes or variation in the open loop gain don't affect the closed loop gain. A classical example of gain desensitivity through feedback is the meter resistor in the biasing of the BJT. The collector current is this, and it depends on beta, which is temperature dependent. So if the temperature increases, the beta increases, then the collector current increases as well. Increasing the collector current makes the temperature increases even more, and this can go on till some damage occurs. This phenomenon is called thermal runaway. Moreover, this dependence on the temperature makes the gain of the stage temperature dependent, thus showing different gain at different temperatures. In order to solve this problem, we use a negative feedback by means of the emitter resistor. This time, if the collector current increases, the voltage drop on the emitter resistor increases, thus decreasing the VBE voltage, which in turn makes the collector current decrease. You see, this is a negative feedback because the input signal VBE is now the difference of the source signal VIN and the feedback signal VRE. The open loop gain is this and the closed loop gain is this one. Negative feedback also increases the usable bandwidth of an amplifier. Assuming that an amplifier has the frequency response given by this equation, AOL H of S is simply the high frequency dependent version of AOL and it is approximated using a first order pole at omega H. Putting this equation into that of the closed loop, we get this other equation and sorting things out, we get this final equation, where you see that now the pole is not at omega h, but at an higher frequency, which is omega h times the loop gain at zero frequency, so AOL times beta plus 1. We see also that the gain at low frequency is decreased by the same amount that the bandwidth has increased. Here you see the open loop gain in solid line as function of the frequency and also the closed loop gain in dashed line. You see here in red that the closed loop gain is lower than the open loop one, but the bandwidth is larger. If we decrease beta, the gain increases and the bandwidth decreases. If beta is zero, we come back in the open loop situation. For example, if we see the frequency response of a common emitter amplifier, we see that the dominant pole is this, where the capacitance C mu between base and collector is magnified by the Miller effect. Note that here the emitter resistance RE is used only for biasing purposes because of the presence of the bypass capacitance C2, which shortcuts the emitter to ground when frequency is above zero. So, in the small signal analysis, we neglect RE and this amplifier has not a feedback. So, that the gain as function of the frequency is this, where omega P1 is the dominant pole and omega 0 is the zero. So, the bandwidth is this one. Here you see the high frequency response of a common emitter amplifier with emitter degeneration resistance which work as feedback. The dominant pole is now this one in which you see that 1 plus GM RE factor which makes smaller the denominator thus making larger the frequency of the dominant pole. The zero is now this where again you see the loop factor this time making smaller the frequency of the zero thus enlarging the bandwidth. You see in red the bandwidth with the feedback effect. Negative feedback can also improve the nonlinear behavior of an amplifier. Examine the transfer curve of the voltage amplifier without feedback. Ideally, the amplifier should have a straight line from the Vin between plus and minus 2 volt. However, a nonlinear behavior in the amplifier causes a different slope to occur when Vin is larger than 1 volt and Vin is less than minus 1 volt. Since the gain of the amplifier can be defined as the slope of the transfer curve, we can deduce that the gain is this for Vout between plus 10 and minus 10, and this for Vout larger than plus 10 or less than minus 10. Now, suppose that the feedback is applied around the amplifier with beta equal 0.1 and the transfer curve is redrawn. The gain of the amplifier with feedback becomes this for Vout between plus and minus 10 volts and this for Vout larger or less than 10 volts. You see from the result in the diagram that there is a linearization. An example of linearization through feedback is the emitter degeneration resistance which introduces a negative feedback. Without feedback, the gain is minus GMRC, so it depends on GM, which is a nonlinear element. We assume linearity just for very small signals, so for Vin much less than the thermal voltage. But when Vin increases, distortion starts. If we see the gain with the feedback, so the closed loop gain, we see that if RE is much larger than 1 over GM, then the gain becomes this, so it becomes independent of the nonlinear factor GM. We can understand this by realizing that the input voltage is divided into a big component dropping on RE and a little component dropping on the base emitter junction, which produces the nonlinear behavior. As larger is RE in comparison with 1 over GM, which is the emitter resistance, as linear is the behavior. In fact, RE and 1 over GM work as voltage divider. Input and output impedances of an amplifier can be controlled using negative feedback. In this way, we can modify the total input and output impedances by amplifying them or decreasing them by a factor equals to the loop gain, so 1 plus AOL times beta, as you can see in the table. Note that the closed loop impedances are completely dependent on the type of variable that is used, voltage or current, at the input and the output. If the input variable XS is a voltage, the closed loop input resistance Rinf is equal to the open loop value of the input resistance Re multiplied by the value of 1 plus AOL. And if the output variable is a current, the open loop output impedance is multiplied by the same factor. In our example of a BJT with and without emitter resistor, we have that an input voltage is transformed in an amplified output current, so we are in this situation and we should see both input and output impedances magnified by the gain loop. Using our example of a BJT with and without the emitter degeneration resistor RE, we see that the input resistance is this in the configuration without feedback, and this other in the configuration with feedback, where you see that Rπ is magnified by 1 plus GM RE. The output resistance of the common emitter configuration is this, and that of the emitter degenerated configuration is this one, which becomes this if RE is much less than Rπ. So you see the output resistance of the BJT RO is magnified by the factor 1 plus GM times RE, as we expect. The magnified resistance is only that of the BJT, which is our amplifier. I leave a link in the description for the characteristics of the common emitter configuration of a BJT. Please leave me a comment, let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put a thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.